people, okay, usually when I fight, the most of them, when I have this arm, that's the first thing that they do. They come to here and they are very strong and they grab me here, grab the belt or whatever, and they throw me over that way. Boom! See, but they can only go up to here. That's it, maximum. And then the mistake that everyone does is let go the rope when it's falling on the cliff. Let go the elbow. So the guy does that, the guy goes up, and then, brother, doesn't matter what happened here, he is stronger than me. And then he will lift you. Especially when you fight someone heavier than you. I find this. Like, guys, like, on my case, heavier than me because I'm 90 kilograms, the guy from 100 kilograms. They just get me, boom, wanna throw me. But they can only go so far. But you need to believe and trust that as long as you have the elbow, put your forehead on the ground, he cannot go any further than that. And then you're gonna take advantage of that movement to catch a better position, which will be controlling the other elbow that you didn't have in the first place. Okay, so I'm here, he starts pushing me away, look, one, and put my hips down, all right? Now, he's gonna throw me over, look, hips down, forehead on the ground, he cannot go, lift me up, more video. That's the max that can go, now look, shift, one, and two, and now I have both elbows. See that? So, he can only lift me so much because he's stuck by his own elbow, okay? And then he's gonna get in the end that he cannot go any further. So he's gonna get frustrated, he can't go any further, but it will be there when you're gonna shift your hips and then come back on the knees again and release the only pressure that he had to lift me up, which was his right hand. Okay? So remember, he's here, he's strong only on my hips. That's why I overcommit forward. So I go forward. Boom. Look, he goes up, look, hips, shift, come back. So with my right leg, he lift me up here, boom, okay? With my right leg, I will turn, look, one, and then come back with my left under, and then come back in. And like that, I caught his far arm. So, one more. So, when I'm control here, I overcommit myself, he pushes, look, one, two, and three, and then, it is a great position to be at. Why is great position? Because he cannot push me away at any position. He doesn't have nothing to push me out. And I'm completely tight on him. Okay? So here is time to attack again on the north and south. Look, one, two, go over, control, see? And I have, once more, a good attack here. All right? And he's completely under pressure. Okay, so we already got a lot of few little tips that gives you the scenario of the side control positioning. Okay, so one, let's see what's missing. We had like the normal traditional position. When he pushed me out, I catch the elbow this way. When we have the both arms across, the tip, how to keep squeezing all the time, you know? I say we did like one, two, okay? Usually, remember, this position over here, we had like the control on the hips, remember? So this position is good for me either to settle down the position and control, okay? Or attack, okay? So this hand, okay, go back here. This hand here become like an anchor, stops and lock. Because what people do, if you grab him, every time that I walk around, he follows me. No, it's like, yeah. See, I walk around and he just keep following me, follows me. That's not good. So what I need to do, I put my hand before, and then when I try to go, he follows me. He can't go follow, see? And then I can go here. It is when I start attacking and go for the figure four, okay? I use this figure four a lot. On the side control, even to control, not even to submission. The guy here, he can't move much. Even if I go around here, you know, he can't move much because if he roll away from me, that's the only time that, the only place that he can roll is away from me. So if he tries to roll away from me, he's just gonna get in the arm. Look, whack. All right? And then if he tries to roll in me, he can't because I have the elbow under control. So this is a very good position as well to establish yourself and then get him to give you the technique to submit. Okay? So, all right, we already went over the most of positions around the side control. Okay? Because that's what I want to do. I want to give you a picture what can he do against me and what should I do to deal with his escapes or setup for attacks. So we notice how important is control the elbow and squeeze the hips together, okay? And then every time the guy push me out and then lose the battle, it's time to change either for this or for this, as long as I keep the elbow control. I have this here. Don't forget, always pinch. If you're losing the elbow, start pulling back. If you lose the elbow, level, look, reset. Reset. It's not point to insist in something that you're losing, okay? So every time that you lose the elbow, make sure you reset somehow, okay? Other situation that we did, shifting, changing the hips, okay? Attacking the arms, okay, and everything. So we're gonna do another series of attacks from this position, okay? You're gonna do a series of attacks from the north and south. But at the moment, I wanna make sure that you guys can control yourself, your partners or your training partners, okay, opponents, when you train. All right, so if you focus, the best thing to do to improve your BJJ, okay, that's one thing that I learned a lot with my instructor, Zé Ariola, it's like specific training is the key. You got to train specifically. If you just keep sparring every day that you go there, just go there and keep fighting each other, you're just gonna get tough on what you already know. You need to get better on things that you not usually happens on the normal fight, okay, all the time on the fight. So if people cannot pass your guard, so how are you gonna learn how to escape from the side control if you don't get there? So I advise very much get different situations, side control, mount, half guard, back position, third position, close guard, and train specifically to be able to improve your techniques. So when next time that you train on the side control, get these points and keep always controlling on the position. Make sure you have the elbows under control and all the time try to bring the hips in, you know, and then I'm gonna show a few drills later how to keep the guy under control on the side control when the guy passes over the angle that you lost the position and how to deal with it, okay? So first of all, let's get this right. Let's control the elbow all the time. So I'm gonna do a little experiment with Victor, okay? So I'm gonna try to move away from me and I'm gonna try to deal with the elbows and I'll show you how we control, okay? But already go out here, see? Stop. Look, notice this. This is a very good point that happens here. I was here, Victor, I was very low here, and then my main problem was this hand instead of this, okay? Because I had strong, I was strong enough to keep controlling now, so he couldn't lift my head out. You know, I was there, but he started lifting my hips. Like, yeah, see? And then his knee, he started being bothered. And then if I keep insist with my hips the way that it is, he's gonna regain guard here. Okay? But I don't wanna lose that. So, this is an important thing. So, I was here, he focused on the right hand, start pushing me up, the right hand, look. I need to shift it straight away to be able to don't lose the technique. All right? If I keep trying to the same position here, sooner or later you're gonna lose. That's how it becomes, you need to mold on the situation. All right? So, look at that. The hips, the lower body, works exactly the same way of the upper body for the control. It's about feeling. Okay, that's a good important thing to do specific training. Okay, look. The first thing we had was he pushed my neck up. Look, my hips is down. He cannot lift both, you know, because I'm just I'm gonna be stable in one of the places. If he lift this one here, what I do? I shift the upper body. But he starts lifting this one up, I shift the lower body. But I always don't lose. As soon as I feel my hips going up or my leg going up, I need to change and control the hip, the elbows together. Okay? And like that, that's when you're gonna start using the technique. Okay? I'll keep going again. Look, little tip. I told you how important is the elbow, yeah? But sometimes you it's slippery. Sometimes it's falling, or I start missing the elbow. What just happened with me, because Victor is a very strong guy. When I change here, when I change, my elbow is already going out. I put below my hand, okay, but to secure, because the elbow is already on the edge. If I miss this, I lose everything. So what I did, I put the hand below my to secure the elbow, and the hand, the right hand now, I will grip, and I'll make sure that the elbow doesn't go slide through, and like that gives me security that I won't miss the elbow. So that's why I stay a little longer on the position, to show you how tight I was. So I control here, look, control the elbow, and like this, look, he tried to push me away, look, he can't push me away because I have the elbow, all right? And then he's gonna get frustrated sometimes. Look, I start going to the side, look, boom, he start controlling his elbow below, so now I have already the both elbows under control. So he didn't need to move me upwards, okay? And then if he does move me upwards, with this grip here to secure the elbow, makes me more stable, because sometimes if you push me out, and then I go up here and slide the elbow, like, yeah. So I'm here, if I just control here, and I'm not tight enough, he's gonna lift me up, look, oh, too late, too gone, you know? So what I do, to secure, I control, I grip with my right hand, keep tight in the lock, so like that when he throw me over, look, he doesn't wanna lose, okay? In this case, his elbow is too deep. I don't have enough time or space to throw. What I'll do, I go straight to the north and south. He push me up. Look, I just keep going to north and south. Oh, and lock and have the arm. Right? So this how works the transitions. If you see things, you need to make it up things to get what you want. Okay? You notice that how little things changed to have the control. I wanted to have the elbow, I didn't have the grip in the first place, but when I start feeling that I'm gonna lose, make somehow to keep the key point under control, all right? So these here are a few tips from the top control on the side control.